Coming to you from deep inside the vaults of the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, here is Tom Holmes, your curator and guide to vintage electronic music and audio experimentation.
This episode, Refined Noise. Listeners to this podcast know that I have a fondness for electronic music consisting of noise, ambient and electrical, musical and non-musical. I've had several episodes exploring recordings around this subject of noise. In August of 2020, I did a podcast called Noises from the Past, which was a short history of noise music with vintage recordings of examples that blended music and noise. In May 2021 and March 2020, my episodes called New Arrivals to the Archive featured several recent discoveries of contemporary recordings of electronic music with noise. I have also featured elements of noise in several other episodes, along with industrial and radio broadcast sounds, telephone sound, computer noise, and so forth. Noise is a subject of which I never seem to tire. As much as I appreciate industrial music with loads of noise, walls of noise, I also have a fondness for the adept application of noise elements, non-musical sounds, to an overall fabric of music that contains noise without being totally unhinged. And to these kinds of examples, I dedicate this episode. All of the details of the tracks are found on my podcast website. We will hear a limited release recording of Klaus Baumler, a visual artist from Hamburg, mostly known for his art and video work. In 1996, he created a mosaic of sound from cassette recordings, including all kinds of common interesting sounds. In 1977, musician David Cunningham had a recording that captured his process of working with an ensemble in which mistakes that were made were cues for the other players to continue in that vein. The two works included here, one for guitar and the other for water sounds, are solo works in which he replicated that process used with the ensemble. From 2013, we have some work by Luke Fowler, which uses piano and synthesizer. Then one of my favorites, Merzbau, collaborated with the female artist Genesis Porridge in 1999 on a recording rich with musical noise and audio processing. Then from 1960, I have an unusual and rare recording from Emery Cook of Cook Recordings. Cook was known for making high-fidelity location recordings and musical records from the mid-50s to the 60s. He patented a special vinyl pressing technique called microfusion to produce high-quality vinyl records, originally monophonic records, but as you will hear, this recording is a microfusion recording, but it is also stereo. When he wasn't releasing sound effects, such as Mexican firecrackers, or location recordings of calypso music, steel bands, or a Creole Christmas, Cook managed to slip a few strange experiments into his catalog. This record, number 40850, comes from a series of five albums he produced around 1960 that combined musical tracks from his other albums with a track of pure white noise. The music would play on the left, the white sound, as he called it, would play at the same time on the right. I have several of these discs, plus a demo album that Cook produced to illustrate the concept. The tagline for the White Sound series was, quote, analgesic sound for control of tensions, unquote. The cover stated boldly that the album was, quote, the new analgesic white sound to help in control of tension, headaches, insomnia, appetite, smoking, a natural relaxant, unquote. After the Microfusion album, we will have something by Mincemeat or Ten Speed, an electronic musician from Rhode Island, for whom I have a test recording made in 2010. And we will finish up with an album side of very refined noise music by Susie Poling, sometimes known as Pod Blots. What you are hearing in the background right now is Mika Vinio, an album called Ludspur, Part 1. Mika was an electronic musician, composer, and producer from Helsinki. This was a record produced and curated by Paul Smith in 2018 with Moog technical support and engineering by Finlay Shakespeare. It was part of a limited series of Moog albums produced at the University of Surrey in the UK when the university was home to a set of Moog modular synthesizers and components lent on an arrangement with Moog Music USA that Paul Smith made happen. So go to my blog, Noise and Notations at tomholmes.com, for a transcript of the notes for this episode. So let's get started on this edition of the podcast called Refined Noise. This is Tom Holmes, and you are listening to the Archive of Electronic Music. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
You are listening to Refined Noise on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Tom Holmes.
Need to have Yeah. Thank you. We'll be right back.
I hope you enjoyed Refined Noise on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Tom Holmes. Details about all of the music can be found in the playlist on the podcast website. Check out my blog for the Bob Moog Foundation. There is a link on my podcast website. And a transcript of notes of the program are found on my blog, Noise and Notations, located at tomholmes.com. If you would like to learn more about the history of electronic music, please read my book, Electronic and Experimental Music, published by Routledge, in print or as an ebook. You may also want to read my book about sound art, also available from Routledge. If you enjoyed this podcast, I invite you to explore our library of past episodes. They span many genres, technologies, and artists associated with electronic music, from symphonic rock to music for meditation, and of course, noise, all inspired by vintage recordings from my archive. So long for now from the Archive of Electronic Music. Happy listening.
All of the music heard on this podcast is brought to you from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a curated collection of vintage recordings. For a complete playlist, go to the holmesarchive.podbean.com. All crackles, surface noise, and other imperfections heard in this podcast are purely intentional. All intro, outro, and other incidental music is by Tom Holmes, unless otherwise noted in the playlist. For notes about this episode, please see the blog Noise and Notations at tomholmes.com. So long from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music.